Stream avatar is my avatar. My mic is working. And thing is working. Okay. Alright, time to wake up. That is not happening. I got two vaccines in me, and boy, is it hitting me hard. But I'm still here, and I'm still doing this. This is what I want to do. Everything else be damned. And the thing that I'm doing is... The thing that I'm doing is... super fun tutorial stuff. Everybody finds that super fun, right? Okay, what's this about? Probably about the text here being... negative one is okay. I know this is an issue. But that's the next thing I wanted to iron out, is that it shouldn't be exploding immediately. It should be exploding. Why are you exploding immediately? You should explode a little later. This was fine just a moment ago. Why are we starting off with dumb nonsense here? Why did I slap a space in here? Okay, So what do you mean? Because I added extra lines to the text file? Oh, or maybe it is exploding because these are not... You can't find everything in this. I guess I could just put a bunch of... semicolons to delineate it. Yep. Definitely delayed. I slow today. Yes, okay, so... if I do... that, but then do just a bunch of nothing here instead, and then do a nice negative one. Okay, so one, and then two, and then three, and then four. So we'll do this and see if that causes the non-explode. But I think that really means it's just gonna read it, which I didn't really want. So, the thing I need to do is actually pause it if it is a that's what the instrument of this is coming from. Show a little hand that says tap here, tap there. The question is, how do I while. So action completed is going to be true. It's gonna start with action. Well, no, this should just be a spot that resets it. Which is probably what this would be. It's just here. Yeah, I really did not need to be doing the stream because I'm like, I am fighting just exhaustion and a headache, and probably not gonna be a long stream, but who knows. I'm doing okay, I'm not doing bump myself on Discord. I guess. I know friendos were online like yesterday and stuff, but. And then I'm never doing anything interesting, so. I do need, because it's gonna be false at the beginning, so. Yeah, because it's attached to that there, I need to do it. Well, I guess this is where I would determine if the action has been completed. Actually, maybe that's true. Maybe that's where I should do the action completed. But processing dialogue also does that. I could just check the dialogue then. So if the dialogue parser contains process dialogue num. So now if this contains pause for completion, maybe wait for completion. Just to confuse myself, just to change it, just to confuse myself. But if this contains, yeah, this is the dialogue. Then action completed is true if it's not waiting for it, otherwise it is false, meaning it is waiting for it. Okay, so I will obviously need to change that, but this should, hopefully this should hang when it gets to that menu. Hey, there we go. Okay. Either I need to make this bigger or make the text smaller. We'll make the text a little smaller. The text on the dialogue is, let's do 50, I guess. I don't know. I wanted to think about that. Oh, that's my microphone. It's picking up some kind of background noise, I guess. Very minor, though. The question I was trying to answer is the thing that I just tweaked, which was, oh, so this does not need to be there anymore. Because I have this. Oh, the text. The text is what I just tweaked. Why'd you just explode, huh?
I took out a bool, and now you're like, oh god, it's too much. Yeah, that's the text color, so I'm like, can I do that? Yeah, okay, so then I need to determine if a unit has moved. Well, basically, this needs to be disabled. Because right now, you could just do that. And it's just hung on a thing anyway, so... I could make this smaller. Because right now it's covering up that player one, player two thing. Yeah, and I do say tap. Tap to move, which does work here. I don't know why that's worked there. I'm so glad this is fixed. That was such a pain when I was trying to demo it and that wasn't working, but thank you for the follow. You caught me at a time where I'm kind of zoned out, but hopefully this is interesting. And I'm also working on a tutorial, so again, not the most interesting, but I like to win a regular stream just to get stuff done, though. Or does this still... Okay, good. It does not do anything. Okay, now I need to check the... And an Indie Gamiacs. Hello, hello. Yeah, I'm getting... I should probably be doing, like, an itch.io page and, like, a Steam page, but... I'm getting, like, so close to having, like, a full demo. That's really what it was just the itch.io page. I want to have it as good as it can be, so I wanted to get, like, a full, actual playable demo. But something like a Steam page I can throw together. I have enough screenshots and stuff. Okay, now. That is also an issue. So. Yeah, get the Steam page up to start collecting wish lists. Yeah, that was the event that I just did, was, basically they gave us, like, a week and a half notification that, hey, you're part of the event, and it was like, oh, do I want to get a demo done, or do I want to get a Steam page up, and I was like, oh, we're gonna get a demo done, that's gonna be more important for the, because it was gonna be, like, I didn't want to rush, like, try to get it done so that it could get approved in a couple days before the event, but now I really should. A Steam page up, but I've gotten so sucked in to try, because the demo is so close to being fully done. Like, if I can get a tutorial, then it'll actually be a functioning thing. Oh, okay, so that's, I should probably mark that down. I think I just got scared looking at the Steam page, where it's like, oh, you need to have all these assets, and these assets, and these assets, and I'm like, well, I guess I do have a header that... that I can make different sizes and stuff, so that's a somewhat of a chunk of it, but well, it's putting the best foot forward, and I'm trying to get the game into a point where it's the best foot forward, and then I can slap the photos on Steam, but I know I can also update stuff on Steam, so that's what I should be focusing on, but I just like game development stuff, so that's what I've been messing with. Especially because this is so close. Okay, I was getting distracted, clearly. I was also going to mark down on my Trello that I'm trying to be a little more organized. I don't really need all those tabs. Slap it over here. There we go. So now this is a... Oh, I already did all of these. So, highlight kings. I kinda did. I need to throw that under a bug, then, I guess. I feel like I want to get rid of some of these. Just because this is the part that I mess with, that I have to scroll over to get there. Okay, but bugs was... So disable controls until proper tutorial moment. Well, I think it's also because I'm trying to throw a lot of weight behind this project. It's like, I actually want to put it on Steam. I actually want to have a release of something somewhere instead of my large pile of just half-finished things. But that was part of my impetus behind the, like, I'm going to leave my job, and maybe that'll force me to actually finish something. Also, I just wasn't a fan of the job at that point. I'm like, I'm good. I'll go find something else. I know this is not the time to be finding a new job, but I think we'll be okay. Yeah, vital to actually release. Yeah. I got plenty of stuff on Itch, so at least there's some playable games and stuff. But I know it's vital to release on either a Google Play or an iOS or a Steam, like an actual marketplace that people can purchase stuff. I'm like, I made this purchasable thing. But yeah, and I know the big thing is that the gulf between actually releasing something and just kind of dropping it somewhere is two entirely different things. Because that's definitely what happened with this game. Where I got a mobile game up onto the Amazon App Store, and then it got torn apart because people just couldn't figure out that it was a balance game, despite the fact that I wrote that in the summary. I think it helps that I added a video, but that was well after the fact. But it is a little bit of a bummer that, like, these are just harsh reviews when it's like, it's a super simple balance game, and you just didn't read the instructions that it was a balance game. Don't listen to me, I have a million projects not completed. And I think that's a good artist, too, is that you do a lot of things. You just crank out quantity. But there is an art to actually, like, putting something out, too. Oh, that's part of the reason I was sort of looking at my itch, was just because I wanted to find that. I didn't make a page for, like, a Where's Waldo or anything today. But yeah, there's this hide-and-seek that I have. It's mostly done, but I also didn't have an ability to hide the Twitch chat, so it was a little harder to say, like, oh yeah, hide from the streamer, and then, oh, the streamer could just read your Twitch message just to where the character went. But yeah, I also have to redo the lobby on this, and I was just like, And I think I kind of missed my moment in terms of making a Vampire Survivors versus Twitch chat. Which I might still do, depending on how well this game goes. That is the other thing, is I'm like, I want to get this game up on a Steam page just to see how it wish lists and stuff. Which should give me a good sense as to, do people actually like this? Do people want to see more or not? Which I probably should have had done before leaving job, but I was just sick of the job, so I don't remember what I was doing beyond... Okay, wait, I was doing this, disable controls. So I also need to put this in a different, like, tutorial scene there. Yay, team quit. Hey now, I haven't quit any of these projects, they're just in indefinite hiatus. They're just, at least something like this. Yeah, this one is released, but just because it was a, Oh, yeah, team quit on jobs? Yeah. I know, like, I've heard of friends and stuff doing it and stuff, too, and I'm like, I'm pretty sure it's gonna be completely fine in the long run, but when parents call up saying, don't do that, that's not a good idea, and I'm like, yeah, I know it's not a good idea, but I'm getting older, and I'm going to die at some point. Might as well do this while I'm young. I am just thoroughly distracted. I'm trying to disable the controls. Yeah, and I haven't even finished my full, like, 2 weeks notice out of the job, so I'm still kind of there, which is a weird one, but I'm all on board with that sentiment. Yeah, it's just, it's stressful. Like, it was nice that, like, all my coworkers and other family members have all been supportive of, hey, this is a good thing, and you've been talking about it for a while, but it's just a bummer. My mom tells me to go beg for my job back. I just wish that my parents were a little more supportive. But I'm also my own person. I'm old enough now that I can do my own thing, and I shouldn't let it get to me, but that's still easier said than done. Okay, so you are the determining the controls. I don't want to add a in-tutorial thing. Well, this also has a... Yeah, I figured some of just leaving a job would also force, like... also getting up, other store pages and stuff, too. Because I'm like, I have a mostly done Redbubble page for doing my pixel art, and I still haven't finished it. Like, I got all of this stuff up on Redbubble, and I spent a while getting it all there. And I just haven't hit the button. Hit the go button. But I also think Redbubble's gonna get me, like, cents per month, if I'm lucky. It's not gonna be a lot. Yeah, I was looking into doing more, like, pixel assets and stuff, too, just because I have... Because I know I can use this character generator and just slap different clothes on characters and have all sorts of options. Yeah, there's lots of options, lots of directions I can go, and I just need to do all of it. And I will be excited to do that when I have all of my time to me. I was looking at the input for this. All ideas have a chance to grow. It's worse if you were not having any. That's true. I called my friend from college on a somewhat regular basis, as in like a couple times a year. But that's his sentiment to me is always like, just keep going, man. Keep doing it. Don't be me. I'll just work a job and that's it. I've bounced around enough jobs too to know that it's not gonna last or be important. Another reason why I focus on my stuff. Okay. So you... I could probably attach a tutorial to this. It's not to every single unit. And this is the... Well, the issue here is that this is just a... I can make a unit selected. What would be the best way to disable this? Well, it's here I can disable that, but then the unit is still clickable. Oh, I guess I could do... I could just say if it's in tutorial mode. So let's do A. Naturally, I actually have people in my stream to talk to when my brain is just so full of fuzz. I'm not here right now. getting multiple vaccines at once is a lot. I'm glad I'm not having any symptoms. I'm just exhausted. And it definitely didn't help me sleep. Where do I want to put this? Okay, I want a... probably there, but... heading to bed, just wanted to say hi. That's... yeah, again. It's always people across the pond. It's always middle of the night people across the pond. I don't know why I appeal to that audience, but... it might just be time of day, too. Might just be dinner for a lot of people. But thanks for stopping by. I know I said it in a YouTube comment, but I'd love to do some more game dev podcast stuff. Because I have so many different projects and stuff, too. I've just made... I mean, it's frustrating looking at jobs, because I'm like... I have so much experience in so many different things. And they're like, do you have a bunch of experience in one particular thing? It's like, no, I have a generalist, so... it's almost back? Okay, yeah, I saw the video that said it's coming. And I enjoyed the couple of game dev podcasts I've been on. Yeah, because it's always the fun thing, too, is, like, this isn't even all of the projects that I've done. Which is what I was trying to drop on itch.io to have more stuff there, but... send me a Google form for the podcast? Okay, yeah, because the thing I saw in the video that was, like, just use the email in the link. And I was like, I didn't even see an email, but I figured I wouldn't worry about it until the podcast was actually up anyway. Plus, I don't have... I want to get at least an itch.io page and ideally a Steam page up before... more promotion, but I do have all of my other social medias and stuff too, so although the one event I did just recently, but oh, it's there, I'll move it to the top. Okay. Yeah, I didn't look at it too thoroughly there, but yeah, the one dev event I did recently, I was like, here's all my social medias, and everybody took business cards and nobody followed. There was not an uptick in followers. That was a bummer. Okay, I was adding this tutorial. I definitely have a tendency to push myself when I'm feeling bad, too. I'm like, oh, that's the time to push yourself when you don't want to do it. And I'm like, no, when I'm recovering from a vaccine and feeling a little sick, that's not the time to push myself. Wait, this isn't repeating, is it? No. This just happens to sound familiar. Tutorial. Okay, let's just put it in tutorial mode and see. Probably still be able to select the unit, but I'll see what breaks. I was quite surprised at an in-person event that essentially a turn-based board game actually still garnered a fair amount of interest. Okay, so can I click a unit and... yes. Oh, I can't actually move the unit. You should be not selectable. Oh, which was gonna be a... get in this tutorial. Again, I'll slap it at the bottom. This is not how you do... well, this is how I do code. This is not... not a good way to do code. That's not what I typed. That's not what I wanted. Anyway. I think this should be game manager, but I just kind of called it the spawn. I know Unity has a specific like game manager thing. And then we'll return this tutorial. I do kind of want to go through and rewrite everything at some point, but we'll see. That's also dependent on, like, I want to get a full demo version of the game fully up before I do that. So, now that I have the is tutorial, I can do review. Spawn. It's not spawn that is to get this tutorial. There we go. So then it shouldn't be able to switch whether it's selected or not, so I don't even need to worry about that. So hopefully, and it's already got the spawn attached to it, so does that disable everything? It should. Yes. There we go, so then it should re-enable it. It's does this have a spawn? Like I said, at this point, I think I'll just buy it. So then wait for completion. Using Twitch as a therapist again. Just kind of complaining in the void. So, set this tutorial. I do need a setter as well. Was I doing getters and setters, or was I doing? I believe I was doing getters and setters. Do I have even more, like, just vibing and falling asleep kind of music? Oh, wait, I know, what's this face? It's actually not. It's not his on Twitch. Oh no, what is the name of the artist? Well, if I just go to my Bandcamp, that'll tell me the stuff I've purchased. There we go. Yeah, it's because I have no clue how to pronounce that. Okay, I want to do a different... I love this artist, but let's do this artist that I also love. Let's do a different thing here. I was using the same thing. It's just his tutorial. I'm not doing all this. Okay, so that is that, and then that is that. So now you do a tutorial. Contains wait for completion. And the action has not been completed. Yeah, it's only if the action's been completed that it continues. It's probably easier ways to do this, but again, that's. I'm not good enough or smart enough to
figure out what I want to do and then do it. I do what I do and then figure out what I did.
Which I was definitely seeing at the event that I went to, is that people would take an action and figure out what it did instead of trying to. I did not sit, did I? I never do. I always forget the last step of actually connecting with things. So then how do I determine if the action is completed? Is the real question. Well, because I could just do a... This is within an update anyway, so... Get end of turn. Possibly. Oh, that was the one issue with this, is that... It's not SoundCloud. I have to go manually keep all the songs going, but so in that case, find me an album. Not an album. Also not an album. Hey, look, it's an album. That can bugger off. Oh wait, is it messages? Or is it this? Oh, that is Twitch messages. Oh, well. Thank you. Man, it's such a bummer that the internet is full of so many bots, because I get distrustful of any... random messages. So, this is just a bool of get end of turn. So, it's basically a if you manage to take an action, any action at all, then it will be. See what that does. So I I need to fix up that font still. There's a lot of little things to do. There's a ton of polish to do still, but I wanted to finish the tutorial. Okay, so none of that's working, which is good. There, and now it should be possible to do stuff. And then it's still active. The end of turn should have happened though, right? Is that not what I thought it was? Probably isn't what I thought it was. So what is that that I just was trying to use? Yeah, give me this. What the heck is this? Return end of turn. So what the heck is this? It should be a... yeah. Reset lock, end of turn. True. And then if it's true... Oh, it's... for one frame, it's correct. Oh, and because the submit button wasn't pressed. Okay, so then how do I want to do that? Well, I do need to keep the action completed and set tutorial. Because that'll reset it, I believe, right? But then I basically need to do this stuff, which is where I would need a method. So in this case, it would be a... Well... That's talking and then process dialogue. I will we'll just do an advanced dialogue and confuse myself. Oh my goodness, okay, add advanced dialogue. That's not how you spell it, is it? No, that is okay. I'm just too tired. Although I'm waking up a little bit, and it's it's that time right before bed that I do tend to wake up. Okay, so now this is the all of this stuff, and then you can be here. So here, so when you complete an action, then it actually advances the dialogue. So now let's try it. Okay, I click stuff, does not do anything. Still do not advance the thing. Boo, hiss, boo. That should be true for one frame. Is that in a late update or something? Where's this again? It's in an update, but... So I guess a late update then? It just feels kind of weird and awkward and bad. No, you. I mean, I might do it just because I'm full of fuss anyway. Which means I probably shouldn't be doing this if I'm going to be making bad decisions, but... I figure making bad decisions is better than making no decisions. I won't sit around doing nothing. I'll make things worse. Okay, maybe that's not a good way. No, it's a first draft. That's really what it is. I'm trying to make a first draft that I can then revise. Or more likely make a first draft and then call it a final draft because revisions are...
just never fun because it feels like you're doing a thing you already did.
Nope, you're still not doing it. Why? Why do you hate me so? So the late update didn't matter. It does trigger though, at some point, right? Yeah, when the lock resets. Oh, it's not resetting, is it? It's not until you advance to the next turn. But even then, it's not hitting that. No, reset lock should be happening at the end of a move. Yeah, stop moving, and then reset lock for player two's turn. So then it's clearing all the locks for player two. It should then be doing the end of turn. It doesn't appear to be picking up here. Or the advanced dialogue is not working because... No, it should be doing something. Because it is advancing the dialogue. Just if it gets to an end of turn, it advances the dialogue, so just... This doesn't appear to be working, so let's... double check that it's not hitting us. Man, I was listening to a different movie soundtrack from the same artist, and then when I went to watch the movie, it was just absolutely awful. So now I'm kind of curious, sort of like, listening to yet another movie soundtrack for a movie I haven't seen. That I wonder if this movie is also just incredibly bad. Okay. There, so then move. No. Despite the fact that it is player two's turn, and that you're letting me play the game. You're doing reset lock, though. It's funny, like, not having that thing there is actually throwing me off. Is that it, or is it just quiet? Oh, they are mostly less than a minute. It's a bunch of songs that are all less than a minute. Oh, okay. Not a full thing. Well, not an album. That's two songs, not enough. I want... might end up just doing that. That's not a full album. That's not a full album. Also not a full album. And this is the one that I really like. So we'll just listen to that. Oh, and I'm not listening to that because I don't know if Twitch will yell at me for it. Okay, so it is not, in fact, hitting this. Or not hitting it long enough for this to hit it. Which is problematic, because I needed to do that. And, like, it is updating the end of turn, though. Is anything actually using this? I guess this is. Yeah, okay, so this is adding a new unit. And repositioning. So this is just... if it's the end of a turn, it's adding a new recruit. Oh, and then it makes it false immediately. Why is this here? Because that doesn't need to actually be there. If it's that short of a... it's like that's literally just run it when you reset lock. This whole end of turn thing doesn't need to be here. No wonder it's not hitting it. It's not actually staying for very long. But wasn't I using that with the abilities? Or was it not? I don't think it was working with the abilities. Which would make sense. Okay, it's setting it to true.
immediately running all of this and sending it to Falls. So it's not even... it's not necessary. At all. So end of turn is not doing anything. Oh, I think I know what I want, is an event that is, that you subscribe to an event that says, hey, that triggered. That was something I missed in my programming learnings, is events. Subscribing and listening to events. No, that is very clearly what I need. I don't want to figure it out right now, though. I'm too fuzz-brained. Okay, end of turn is completely useless, though. Yeah, I just need to subscribe to when it's the end of a turn. Subscribe to whenever a lock happens or something like that. I'm like, is there another way I can do that though? I know I can fake it a little bit if I do. Yeah, get current player. And if it's not equal to one. Like I said, I'll do a code rewrite of everything. Hopefully. We'll see. I don't know. Okay. So you go there. That would make sense. No, wait, it should be false then, right? So then if I do a... and the action completed, if you haven't completed the action, and then this sets it to false. But I think I do want it to set the tutorial to true, though. Definitely not the way to do it. Oh, and then because it's on player 2's turn. Well, if I turn the AI back on, which is what I would be doing in this scenario anyway. Player 1 and AI, player 2 AI. So the AI on, player 1 AI no. Player 2 AI. still here. Why in the heck is it still looping through the thing when it's not? It's clearly still going through the tutorial after the fact. Set talking here, I think, needs to be included in this. That sets it to false in here. And then if it is talking, and then at the end it sets it to false. Right? So yeah, set talking to false. Should stop advancing through the tutorial at the end. Oh, it's not even been an hour! Holy heckums. I am so zoned. Supposed to. Okay, I was supposed to disable that. Okay, help. It still picks up my voice pretty good.
Not as good as. Well, I don't know. Okay, no, that's up into the yellow. Holy balls! I'm so dead. Yeah, it's only barely been an hour. Okay, the thing I was... Wait, was that even... That wasn't even the thing I was testing. There's more issues to... That I should probably mark as well. So I just click a bunch. Oh, it's not on the... But then it's back to player one's turn. Oh, so you, yeah. Okay, so you aren't selectable. Until now. Okay, good. So that is working. No. What do you, what? You mean you're... Because you're showing that because of the fact that the dialogue system is hitting that. What? What do you mean? Okay, talking is true. I click through all of it. Talking is supposed to be set to false. The heckums. Talking. You. You're supposed to be set to false. It said talking to True at the start, but that only happens the once, if talking. Advance through dialogue, and then here. If the dialogue line number equals the line count, set it to false. Equal to, greater than or equal to? Okay, give me you again. So I click through it. So why are you letting me click through here? Okay, so that one is choking up now. And then talking is still true. Why are you not setting it to false? Yeah, okay, so then it is looping. Now it's guaranteed looping through all of it. Set it to false! Oh, it's only if you advance the dialogue. Well, just do it under the flippin' update. Doesn't need to be checked that often, but still, who gives a flying fluff? I was thinking I would do a short stream of, like, to 8 o'clock and just do 2 hours, but that's looking less likely. I'm like, barely making it to here. Okay, dialogue manager. False. So we'll just move you there. What? Now you're doing it. The fluffin' hell! Set it to false! I don't understand. It's not being set back to. No, nobody else is setting it to. So you're telling me the dialogue number. Okay, maybe don't do that then. Just set the dialogue box to false. Because I think that's what's checking that. And then advancing the dialogue should be here, adding to it. Why am I doing plus one? Oh, I can't, yeah, because I can't do plus plus, that's why. Well, let's keep it how it was. That's clearer, and okay. Click through to there. Just want to get it to say false. It was skipping over this earlier. I don't know how it was. Well, now it's. Why are you being picky about it now? What do you mean it's still true? I want to set talking to false. This should be false. That dumb, dad-blasted, mother-flippin' thing should show up as false. Set talking. So is it equal to the line count minus one? I mean, here it should be. So it advances the dialogue. If it's less than the line count. But that means it should be equal to the line count, which is when it'll stop advancing the dialogue. Okay, well then just do it here then. If you're done with the dialogue, set talking to false. Change the variable, you dumb. Yeah, it's me. I'm having the dumb because I'm too tired. I'm too wiped out to be doing this. I don't know. And then it skipped over it. How did it skip over it there? And then are you still... You're still true! How and why is that still true? Set it to false. There's nothing else setting it to true. So you're telling me you never hit... This. What? Shouldn't this be adding to the line number? The dialogue line num? Okay, well then tell me what the heck the number is then. How are you not hitting that? I am clearly too tired to be doing this. If I can't get a loop, a basic loop, to hit the end of the loop. Okay, give me the line. No. Wow. Clearly can't do the caps at all either. So dialogue line num. The heck is this number? Oh, I guess tell me the whole thing. The line count, then. How in the heck are you not advancing the dialogue to the point where that... Because it's while that's less, it keeps advancing, but then eventually it hits the point where it, you hit the end of it. And those numbers should be the same, and when it hits the end of that, it should set talking to false. And nothing else is setting talking to true. It's not like it's being set in an update somewhere, right? Two, three, four, five. There. Six, seven, eight, nine, ten. And there. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. They equal each other. That's what I... So, advanced dialogue. But then set talking is false. False. The fluff in hell do you mean? Meaning talking. It should be false. That's why it's... getting rid of the box then. But then why is this still here? Because that should be set to false. How is that not? It's getting rid of the box, meaning it's setting it to false, meaning this should not be true, and this should also not be true, meaning it shouldn't be doing any of this, like trying to process dialogue numbers. meaning it should not be trying to advance the dialogue, because this is false. The very first thing should be false. I think I sort of got rid of the issue, but it... And this is going to be its own special scene anyway. Talking false. But then I click through it, and it's... talking false, talking false, talking false. And then this is true. How are you doing that? It's setting talking to false, but then I'm still able to click this. Meaning I'm still able to advance the dialogue. Oh, this is... that caused problems. There we go. Was it setting talking to true? I was advancing the dialogue. Why is it skipping the other stuff too? You sucketh! How? What do you mean? It's set to false, and then you keep hitting it. You can't... huh? Advanced dialogue here. It's set to false. So it shouldn't be advancing the dialogue, meaning it shouldn't be hitting this a billion times over. That's the only two references of it. Talking is set to false. It's not true at that point. The fluffin' hell do you fluffin' mean? That it's... what? But I can still click it. It should not be telling me these things. Because talking is false. Unless talking is somehow true. That sets it to true. That is public. I'm not doing that, right? False and true. This is not even being used. This does not exist. I don't have a trigger dialogue. I mean, simply because I'm confused as to how in the world it's doing this. That can go away. It's a bit confusing later when I try to use it. What do you mean? How in the world are you hitting that? It's clearly false, and it's only here. So that's false, meaning you can't advance the dialogue anywhere. False. It's an and. But nothing else is setting that to true. I don't think it's even noticeable. I don't think it even matters at this point, because I'm like, once you finish the dialogue,
it'll just transfer to another scene. But this is the indicator as to when the dialogue is done. But if it can't find that, true. What? That, and that. What? Where? How? What? There's two references. Line 30 is right here. At the very start is when it sets it to true. Otherwise, what do you mean? I'm setting it to false. Nothing else is setting it back. Although, apparently something is setting it back. It's not a public variable either. How in the world are you doing that? What? What do you mean it's true? Where? How? What? It's not a public variable. Meaning nobody else is using this, except for this method, of which it has one that sets it to false, one that sets it to true. The only time it's getting set to true is at the start. But then here, when it's set to false, which I can clearly read the debug, that it's set to false, talking, false, set talking, false. Okay, why is this in the true only? This, the true. This should be, whether you set it to true or false. There. He started talking with a new thing of dialogue. Yes, the box should be active. Yes, that should be zero, and then start with a new line. But if it's false, get rid of the dead blasted box. Oh, it was never setting it to false. That's what was happening. Because it was only if it was true would it set it to true, but if it was false, it would not set it to false, because it wasn't true. Okay, that better be the issue, because I just got rid of the debugs. I've spent half an hour trying to figure this out. This is clearly a go to bed, come back, and then day. Why does it explode into nulls when I do that? I don't... Oh, this doesn't go back this far, if I want to just lean back. Okay, so... look at the dialogue manager. It's fucking false! There we go! Good golly gosh goddamn. Holy fuck face, am I bad at this. That should also... Yeah, I'm doing a lot of tutorial-specific stuff in this dialogues thing that is supposed to be not just for tutorial, but... because I do want to possibly use this in the future for, you know, for like, conversation scenes.
Okay, wait for completion is that so then when it stops talking. Make sure that's so relinquishing control back to the player. Now I need to figure out why in the heck it's skipping over stuff too. And now it's not skipping over stuff. That skipped over stuff. Okay, but now it should be... You should be giving control back to the player. What in the fluff and hell? Okay, it might also be the AI just exploding. It's only 7:30. I don't need to be going to bed now, but I am just... I have a very good excuse. Why does that work sometimes? What are you doing that you're just immediately exploding? Is it the neighbor's issue, or is it the selected unit, or what? Okay, it's a semi-random thing, right? It's not gonna immediately explode every time I try to do this, right? I think some of it was just, I was clicking too fast. But that's also a good thing to test. If somebody gets in the... Why? Why are you for sure exploding now? That should be a semi-random thing, right? Not like a guaranteed explode? No, that's a guaranteed explode, I guess. It's only when it's trying to move something. So what's false? And then the selected unit. Nope, that's action. Well, it's 'cause A is higher than U on the alphabet there. And then the get neighbors, maybe? Which it's also kind of random with its neighbors that it picks too, which should be either one set of four neighbors or one set of that many neighbors. And yet, the AI kind of... Yeah, spawn.selected unit to selected unit.
Take action, selected unit. Selected unit. Well, and I didn't think it would explode if you tried to move a locked unit. I thought it would just not do that. But then obviously it wouldn't be the next person's turn, so then it would just hang. But because all of those, that is a spawn, there is a unit, there is a list, and even if that's zero, then it should be between zero and zero, and then get neighbors of zero neighbors. Is that what the issue is? Is that it's not finding neighbors? It should find neighbors. I set it to one or two. It should find, if you're in the corner, it should find two neighbors at most. Unless it's... Hmm? Everything else exists, so... Yeah, but it is, if it is zero of zero neighbors, and then it still tries to get the first neighbor of zero neighbors, that is, in fact, not gonna work. But it should... Well, at this point, it should not be not finding neighbors. If you are trapped and can't move that unit, then... Oops. Then yeah, that would be the case, but... Why is this phone falling apart? Although I could just say, why am I falling apart? But I know I'm falling apart because two vaccines was too many to do all at once. Okay, this. And then it's only been an hour and a half. I'm probably still gonna go to bed. How and why? It's every time I do a stream that my sister's like, hey, it's time to talk. I've said every Monday and Friday, this is when I stream. It's just the time to talk, I guess. Count zero. Yeah, okay. So it's not finding neighbors. But why are you not finding any neighbors? There is a scenario where you wouldn't be able to find neighbors. But... What do you mean you're not finding any neighbors? It's not like the thing is too crowded for you to not find neighbors. But at any rate, I can stop it from exploding for now. By just saying... Everything else is there, so just the neighbor's count is greater than zero. But I need to go back and figure out why in the heck it's not finding any neighbors. Because it should be finding, even if it's in the corner, it should be finding two neighbors. And yes, if there were two units next to it in the corner, then it would have a hard time finding a movable neighbor, but... Well, and that would only be if there were two locked units, but that's... Well, but it's not... It's just randomly picking.
So is that the tutorial fucking up, or is that the AI fucking up? Because it's just not finding neighbors. What do you mean you're not finding neighbors? This is the exact same stuff I'm using for the movement that is working everywhere else. What do you mean you're not finding neighbors? This is the enemy list. The list of enemies that are on the board currently. Not the list of recruits. Yes, I could see the recruits having a hard time. Okay, whatever. I'm dead, and Sister wants to talk, so I think I will do that. Well, I'll call the stream good, and then still need to do a quick video, but bye-bye, good night, thanks for stopping by. Bye.